Hello everyone, I am Pujita from Talent Battle. Welcome to our new video. In this video, we are going to check some practice questions for numerical ability session for Accenture exam. You can also join our master training classes, which will cover all the sessions that appears in Accenture, like English ability, numerical ability, analytical reasoning, network security and cloud, MS Office and common computer applications, pseudocode and coding with all the previous year questions that appeared in Accenture. You can also join the master classes by using a coupon code which is available in the description box. And you can also join our social media platforms like Telegram group, Instagram page and WhatsApp group. We constantly give updates on placement preparations and off-campus placements. Links for all of this are in the description box. So before we start, do not forget to subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for instant notifications and videos from us. So we'll start. Jason Peralta has a certain amount with him and he goes to the market. He can buy 50 oranges or 36 mangoes. He retains 30% of the amount for taxi fares and food. He buys 18 mangoes and of the balance, he purchases oranges. The number of oranges he can purchase is. So he is having some amount where he can buy 50 oranges or 36 mangoes. So let us consider one orange cost is X rupees. So amount with him will be 50X because one orange is X rupees. So amount will be 50X. Or else you can even write it in terms of mangoes also. So let us consider one mango price will be Y rupee. So amount will be how much at that moment? 36 Y rupees will be the amount. Both of them will be same because he can buy either 50 oranges or 36 mangoes. So the amount right now with him is either 50X or 36 Y. Now, on the way to his market, he is going to spend 30% of the amount for taxi fares and food. Okay, so 30% of this amount. So take any one format, either take in terms of X or either take in terms of Y. I'm going with 50X because it is easy to calculate for 50. So amount spent, how much amount he will spend? 30% of the amount. That means 30% of 50X he will spend. So what is 30% of 50X? It is nothing but 15X. So 15X he spent. So he is having total 50X rupees. So for taxi and food, he spent 15X. That means what is the amount left right now with him? Amount left will be equals to 50X minus 15X, which is 35X rupees will be the amount left with him. Now with this, he is going to buy. How many mangoes he buyed? He buyed 18 mangoes. One mango Y rupee, that means he could have buyed 18 Y mangoes. 18 Y rupees amount he could have spent. Nothing but 18 Y rupees amount he spent. And leftover amount will be there. With that, he is going to purchase some oranges. We need to calculate how many oranges he can buy. Now, the main thing here is we can't take this in terms of Y because we had this in terms of X. So we can't take this in terms of Y. So we are going to convert Y in terms of X. So how can we convert? Observe here, 50X is equals to 36Y. That means I can say Y will be equals to 50 divided by 36X. So let me convert. So this will be nothing but 18 into 50 divided by 36X. So this will get cancelled here. So how much it is? 25X it is. That means to buy this 18 mangoes, he spent 25X rupees. He is left with 35X. He spent 25X. That means how much is the amount left over with him? 10X is the amount left over with him. So with this only, he is supposed to buy the oranges. So how many oranges he can buy with 10x rupees? One orange we imagine x rupees. One orange we already imagine x rupees. So 10x rupees is left. So how many oranges he can buy? 10x divided by x, which is nothing but 10 oranges. So how many oranges he can purchase with that amount? Option C, 10 oranges. A pipe can fill a tank in 14 hours while a leak, which is at 3/7 the height of the tank from the bottom, can empty up to the part in 4 hours. If both are opened simultaneously and if initially the tank is filled, then when will it be 3/7 fill? Okay, so first let's try to understand the question. There is a tank, okay, and particular tank there is a leak which is from 3/7 of the height. That means, for example, if this is the entire height of the tank, the leak will be there here, 3/7 of the height. Okay, so here is the leak. That means what is the height left? Total height is h. This is 3/7. That means 4/7 of the height is left. If you carefully think, the leak cannot empty the water which is down of this. This, the leak cannot empty the water because the leak is up to here. So only this part the leak can empty. This part the leak cannot empty the water. So only 4/7 of the height water only the leak can empty. That is first thing to note. Now they gave us a pipe can fill the tank in 14 hours. So total h liters means h height to fill, it is going to take 14 hours. Okay. And the leak which can empty it in 4 hours. So what is it going to empty? That is going to empty only this 4/7 of the height. And how much time it will take? It will take 4 hours to empty. Now, the tank is completely full. Right now, the tank is completely full. That means entire liters is there. Now, we need to make it as 3/7. At what time it will be just 3/7? That means this 4/7 should be removed. Okay. Now, let's try to imagine the capacity of the tank is equals to 14 liters. Why am I taking 14? Is just because easy for calculation, because it is 14 hours here and here also it is 3/7, 4/7. The denominator is 7. So it will be easy for us to calculate. So I'm just imagining the 14 liters. You can imagine any multiple of 14 also, or you can imagine X also. It will give you the answer. Instead of a variable, considering the value like this will be easy for us to calculate. Now, if I think the capacity is 14 liters, the filling pipe can fill the tank in 14 hours. 14 hours. So 14 liters in 14 hours. That means what is efficiency? Efficiency is nothing but 1 liter per hour. Every 1 hour, it will give 1 liter. Right. 14 liters are there. It will take 14 hours. That means for every 1 hour, it will give 1 liter. Now, what they said, the leak can empty it in 4 hours. What the leak can empty? The leak cannot empty the entire 14 liters. It can empty only this part. That means the leak can empty, when the leak is working, it can only empty 4/7 of 14. That's it. It can't empty the entire thing, which is nothing but 8 liters only it can empty. To remove this 8 liters, how much time it is going to take? It is going to take 4 hours. That's what mentioned in the question. To remove this 8 liters, it is going to take 4 hours of time. So what is efficiency? That means nothing but for 1 hour, how much it is doing? 8 liters, 4 hours of time. So 1 hour, it is going to remove 2 liters per hour. 8 liters, 4 hours of time, which is nothing but 8/4. So 2 liters per hour, it is going to remove. Now the entire tank is filled. The entire tank is filled means total, the initially the tank is filled, total 14 liters are there. Now it needs to become 3/7 full. That means 8 liters should be removed. And what they clearly said, both of the pipes are open simultaneously. That means both of them are working. So observe carefully, when it is filling, it will give 1 liter per hour. When it is emptying, it is going to remove 2 liters per hour. So when both of them are working, what will happen? 1 liter will be incoming. And 2 liters will be outgoing. 2 liters will be outgoing. That means for every 1 minute, if filling and leakage, both of them are there. So leakage is basically a negative work. So we can consider it as -2 because this is removing. So 1 liter is adding, 2 liters is removing. That means for every 1 hour, only 1 liter will be removed from the tank. So here 2 liters will be going up and 1 liter is adding up. So when both of them work, for every 1 hour, 1 liter is going to be removed. Now, if I remove 8 liters, that is enough for us because we need to make the tank 3/7 fill. So to remove 8 liters, how much time it will take? 1 hour, 1 liter it will remove. So to remove this 8 liters, how much time it will take? It will take 8 hours. So what's the answer for this question? Option C. You can take any other value instead of 14 also. You can take X, it will give you the same answer. You can take any other value also, it will give you the same answer. Just to make our calculation easier, I consider 14 here. Okay, so answer for this question is option C. Era sold her watch at a profit of 15%. If she had sold it at a price that was 2% higher, the profit would have been $86.5. Find the price at which she purchased the watch. So first, Sarah will buy the watch at some price and then she sold it for 15% profit. Let us consider the cost price of her will be X rupees. Now the profit is 15%. So profit will always occur some cost price. So 15% of X is the profit. That means what will be the selling price? Selling price will be equals to CP plus profit, your cost price plus the profit, which is nothing but X plus 15% of X, which is 15 divided by 100 into X. Yes, so this is going to give us 1.15 X rupees. So she sold it for 1.15 X, but if he could have increased it by 2%, that means if she could have sell it for an SP of 1.15 X plus 2% of this, if she increased 2% of 1.15 X, then at that moment, she would have got a profit of $86.5. So first, let's calculate how much is the SP here. So 1.15 X plus 2 divided by 100 into 1.15 X. So let us just cancel this here. So this is going to give us 1.15 divided by 50. So this is going to give us 1.15 X plus 203 X. So in total, this is going to give us, if we add both of them, 1.173 X. So if she sell at this particular price, she could have got a profit of $86.5. That means profit will be equals to SP minus CP in general. So what is the profit they gave us? $86.5. That should be equals to SP. How much is the SP right now you need to take? You need to take this as your SP, not this anymore. Because they gave us after increasing the profit will be, that means 1.173X minus what is our cost price? It is X rupees. So if we subtract this, that should be equals to $86.5, right? So 86.5. So what is the difference here? 0.13X will be equals to 86.5. That implies X value will be equals to 86.5 divided by 0.173. So if you just send it this side, it will come. So it will give you the answer as 500. That means answer is option B. So this is one method that you can try for. Okay, so this is the conventional way of solving the question. Entire thing, we assume the cost to price and then we will do. But there is no necessary to do this much procedure for this kind of questions. Just apply some logic. See, for example, if I just think my the cost to price of the watch is 1,000 rupees. Let me just consider cost to price is 1,000 rupees. So at that moment, what will happen? 1,000 rupees, if I go through options, 1,000 rupees. First, if I sell it with 15% profit, what is 15% of 1,000? Just think, what is 15% of 1,000? It is 150 rupees, isn't it? 15% of 1,000 is only 150 rupees. Now, what they said, after increasing, she will get a profit of 86.5. But in the first only, I got a profit of $150 here. So definitely even after increasing, that will be more than 86.5. That means definitely 1,000 rupees is wrong. So for 1,000, for 15% only, we are getting 150. Yes, that means the cost price should be definitely less than 1,000, because for 1,000 only it is more, means for 1,200, 1,800, definitely it will be more, right? So what we can do, we can eliminate all these options because definitely this is not going to happen. So what's the answer? Option B, that's it. If you want, you can quickly cross-check. Actually, there is no necessary to cross-check because the value shouldn't be more than 1,000. There is only one option which is less than 1,000. You can directly take it. Or else if you want, you can quickly cross-check. So if she sell it with 15% profit, that means in 500, 15% of the profit. So how much that is going to cost her? 75 rupees. Yes, 75 rupees. That means she could have sell it for a profit is 75 and her investment is 500. So SP will become 575. Now in this, she is supposed to increase 2%. So what is 2% of this? It is nothing but 11.5. So if we add it, it is going to become 586.5 itself. See, the profit satisfied, 500 rupees she invested and she sold it for 586.5. That means 86.5 rupees is nothing but the profit here. Yes. So basically, there is no necessary even to check also what you can do, if I take 1,000 rupees, if I just think about 15%, it is going for 150. So even if I increase, that won't be definitely 86.5. So your answer should be less than 1,000. So you can eliminate all the options and the leftover option will be only option B. So always make use of the options in your exam. So answer for this question is option B. N tabs numbered 1 to N are fitted to a full cistern. The rate at which the nth tap per N is equals to 2, 3, so on up to N empties the cistern equals the sum of the rate of all the taps numbered before it. If the fifth tap can empty it in 240 minutes, then find the time in which the 10th tap can empty it. Okay, so let's try to understand. There are total 1 to N taps that are filled. And they clearly gave us the rate of the taps. The rate of the taps will be equals to sum of the rates of the taps which is before them. That means, for example, if we take the first tap, okay, if I take the first tap, let me just consider the rate of the first tap emptying is X liters per minute. Why I'm taking minute is because here they gave us 240 minutes. Okay, so if I just think the first tap is going to remove X liters per minute. So the second tap will be also X itself because the sum of the previous, what is the previous? It is only one tap here. So second tap will also be X liters per minute itself. Now what happens to the third tap? Third tap will become the sum of the previous. That means 2X liters per minute it will become. Okay, if you take the fourth tap, okay, if you take the fourth tap, now sum of all the before, that means X plus 2X, which is nothing but 4X liters per minute it will become. Similarly, if you take the fifth tap, it is going to become all the sum, X plus 2X plus again 4X, which is nothing but 8X liters per minute, like this. Okay, this continues. For example, if you take the next one, sixth tap, it is nothing but 16X liters per minute. Similarly, if you take the seventh one, it will be double of that, 16 plus 16, 32. Like that, this keep on going, 32x liters per minute. Okay, now they clearly said us, the fifth tap can empty it in 240 minutes. Okay, 240 minutes, the fifth tap is going to take to empty the tank. The fifth tap will take this much. So we don't know what is capacity of the tank. So first we require to assume the capacity of the tank. So let us think the capacity of the tank is some T liters or some Y liters you can take. So this is the capacity of the tank. Okay. So this is the capacity of the tank. Now, generally what is time period? Time period will be equals to capacity, total capacity divided by efficiency will be the time period. Right? So what is the time period that the fifth tap is going to take? 240 minutes it is going to take. So 240 will be equals to capacity. How much is the capacity we imagine? T divided by what is the efficiency of the fifth tap? It is 8x. Efficiency of the fifth tap, which is nothing but 8x, right? Efficiency of the fifth tap is 8x. Now I got this one. Now what I'm going to do, I don't know what is value of T, what is value of X. So I will just send 8 this side and I will try to identify the value of T by X here. So that implies T by X will be equals to 240, 8 will go that side, it will be multiplication. So 240 into 8, which is nothing but 1920. Yes, so I'll keep this one. Now what I need to identify? I need to identify when the 10th tap can empty. That means first of all, I should know the time taken by the 10th tap means I should know capacity, which we already imagined, T divided by efficiency of the 10th tap. So what would be efficiency of the 10th tap? If you continue this one thing what you can do is you can just continue this one. So 8th tap will be nothing but 64, double than that. So 9th tap will be nothing but 64 plus 64, which is 128. So 10th tap will be nothing but 128 plus 128, which is nothing but 256x, right? The previous one's addition, like that you can take, or you can form the multiples of 2 by using here. Okay, that is also one thing that we can do. Or else you can easily do like this also. That means the efficiency of the 10th tap is 256x. 256x. So let us substitute here. Time taken will be equals to capacity T divided by efficiency is 256x. Now we know T by X value. Can I just write it as 1 by 256 into T by X? So what is T by X value? 1920. That's, I'm just going to substitute here. So 1 by 256 into, just let's substitute T by X value. So it is going to give us 1 by 256 into 1920. That's it. So there is no necessary even to identify what is the value of T and X. There is no necessary also. We can just substitute it here and we can just simply cancel it. So we will try to cancel it. I will directly check whether it is divisible by 128 or not. Yeah. This will go 2 times and this will go 15 times. That means 15 divided by 2 is nothing but 7.5 minutes. So how much time the 10th tap will take to empty the tank? It will take 7.5 minutes. Option B. So if they ask you for the 9th tap, for example, so it is 128x. So you just need to substitute 128x here. If they ask you for the 8th tap, it is nothing but 64x. So you need to substitute 64 here. That's it. So don't try to waste your time in identifying the value of T and X. So you can easily do like this. Okay, so the answer for this question is option B. Thank you for watching the video till the end. If you like the video, do not forget to press the like button. And you can also join our social media platforms. And to join the masterclass, the link is in the description box along with the coupon code. Thank you for watching the video.